Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the Blazor floating action button component. This floating action button appears in front of all screen content and prompts the primary action to be performed. Now, let's add the Syncfusion Blazor floating action button to a Blazor WebAssembly app using Visual Studio 2022. Before proceeding, make sure that you have one of the following .NET SDKs installed in your machine. You should also have one of these IDEs installed. With that confirmed, let's start building the app. I open Visual Studio 2022 and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose Blazor WebAssembly app and click Next. Then, I name my project Button Example and click Next. After that, I continue with the default target framework and click Create button to complete the project creation. The project has been created and is ready to use. If you want to know more about Blazor WebAssembly app and how to add Syncfusion Blazor components to them, click the video link shown in the YouTube card above. Now, let me add the Blazor floating action button component. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor Buttons NuGet package in my application. So, I open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choosing Manage NuGet Packages. Then, I search for Syncfusion Blazor Buttons in the Browse tab. I select this package and install it in my project. I click OK button to complete the installation. I navigate to the imports Razor file and add the Syncfusion Blazor buttons namespace to start using the floating action button in any of the components available in the Pages folder. Next, I open the program CS file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Blazor services by making a call to the method addSyncfusionBlazor. Next, I need to register a valid license key in my application using the RegisterLicense method. To see where to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description. Now, to define CSS for the component, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor themes package. I navigate to the NuGet package manager. And in the Browse tab, I search for Syncfusion Blazor themes and install it. Then, I navigate to the index.html file and reference the CSS file from the installed themes package. I add this script reference manually because, by default, the ignore script isolation option is set to true. And this script reference enables better loading performance for our app. Now, everything is configured, so let me add the Blazor floating action button component. Before adding the button component, I would like to explain the primary action to be performed by the floating action button in this video. You all know that adding a new record to the data grid is one of the primary action in the CRUD operations. So now, I am going to add the floating action button over the data grid component and display it at the bottom right position. The idea here is to show how to add new records to the grid by clicking on the floating action button. As a first step to demonstrate this, I should add the grid component. So, I navigate to the NuGet package manager. And in the Browse tab, I search for Blazor Grid package and install it. Now, I navigate to the imports.razor component and import the Syncfusion Blazor Grid namespace. Then, I open the index.razor component and remove the default content. As I said, I am going to use the Blazor Grid component here. I will add the existing Blazor data grid code snippet. The explanation about this code snippet is mentioned clearly on the Blazor data grid documentation page. If you want to know more about the Blazor Grid component, check out the video link shown in the card above. Now, I will run this example. You can see the Blazor Grid component displayed with defined columns. Next, I will show you how to add floating action button over the data grid component. To do this, first, I define the floating action button component using the SF floating action button tag and set the content property value to add. Here, I have set the button content as add because I am going to add new records using this button. Next, I am going to display this floating action button in the grid. So, I add an ID for the grid component first. Then, assign this grid's ID value to the target property of this button component. Look here, the floating action button is displayed at bottom right corner of the grid. Next, I will show you how to bind the click event to this button to add new records. I add the event on click and assign the event handler add record. And define this event handler inside this code directive. Within this addRecord method, I need to make a call to the grid method addRecordAsync. So, let me create a reference for this grid component first. And using the grid instance, call the addRecordAsync method. Also, I need to enable the allowAdding property in grid to enable the add action on grid. So, let me define the grid edit settings tag. And set the allowAdding property value to true. See now, when I click this button, a new row is added automatically to the grid, and I can fill that row with appropriate values. Next, I will show you how to add an icon to the floating action button component. So, I define the icon CSS property, and set the predefined classes, eIcons and ePlus, to display add icon in the button. See the floating action button component displayed with the add icon. Here, you can notice that the icon is placed at left side of the button content. Suppose you want to change the icon position to top, right, or bottom, then you can use the icon position property. Now, I am going to place button icon at right, so let me define icon position property and set its position as right. As you can see, the floating action button icon is placed at the right side of the button content. By default, the floating action button will be positioned at bottom right corner, but you can also place the button at different positions like top left, top right, top center, middle left, and so on. Now, I plan to position this button at the bottom left corner. I define the position property and set its value to bottom left. You can see the floating action button is positioned at bottom left of the grid component. Next, I will show you how to customize the button style using predefined CSS classes. I plan to apply a border for the button with a transparent background, so let me define CSS class property and assign the predefined class eOutline to it. Here, I am going to position the button at the bottom right, so let me set the position value to the bottom right. The floating action button component is rendered with transparent background, with the border applied. In this video, you saw how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app using Visual Studio 2022 and add a Syncfusion Blazor floating action button component to it. Also, you saw how to add new records to the grid. Using the click event of floating action button. I also showed you how to set add icon to the button and how to customize it using predefined CSS classes. Finally, you also saw how to position the floating action button component. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.